It could be a tough year for selling EVs.
And customers are losing interest in buying them.
But many experts insist the future is still electric. Here's why.
Electric vehicles were supposed to be the answer to one of humanity's greatest challenges, climate change. Promoted as clean, efficient, and revolutionary, EVs became the symbol of a brighter, greener future. But recently, they've hit an unexpected roadblock. Across the globe, governments, industries, and even some consumers are starting to push back. In a twist few could have predicted, EVs are now facing bans and restrictions in unexpected places. Take Europe, for instance, a region often seen as the vanguard of the green movement. In cities like Amsterdam and Paris, officials have begun banning vehicles, including EVs, from historic centers. Why? It turns out that replacing gas-powered cars with electric ones doesn't solve problems like congestion, urban air quality, or road wear and tear. Instead, these cities are focusing on alternative solutions like expanded public transportation, pedestrian zones, and cycling lanes. For EV enthusiasts, it's a sobering realization. Being electric doesn't automatically grant a free pass. Across the Atlantic, California, a state synonymous with environmental leadership, is facing a different issue. The state's electrical grid is under immense pressure, especially during peak summer months. With EV ownership skyrocketing, the demand for electricity to charge these vehicles has skyrocketed too. In response, California has floated the idea of limiting charging hours or introducing tiered pricing to discourage overuse. For a state that mandated a ban on gas-powered car sales by 2035, this development is ironic and troubling. And then there are supply chain issues. The metals required to build EV batteries, lithium, cobalt, and nickel, are concentrated in a few key regions. Countries like Chile, Bolivia, and the Democratic Republic of Congo, which control much of the world's reserves, have started imposing export restrictions to protect their resources. These restrictions are already causing ripple effects, with automakers scrambling to secure alternative sources and rethink their production timelines. These bans and restrictions aren't limited to policy or geography. They signal a deeper, more complex issue, the reality that EVs, for all their promise, come with challenges of their own. Chapter 2, what's fueling these bans? To understand why EVs are facing bans, we need to take a closer look at the issues lurking beneath the surface. 1. The environmental paradox. At first glance, EVs seem like the perfect solution to our transportation woes. They produce zero tailpipe emissions and reduce our reliance on fossil fuels. But their production tells a different story. Mining the materials needed for EV batteries has significant environmental consequences. In Chile's Atacama Desert, lithium mining is depleting already scarce water supplies. Communities that have depended on these resources for generations are now struggling to survive. Similar stories emerge from the Congo, where cobalt mining often involves child labor and hazardous conditions. The green image of EVs begins to fade when you consider the human and environmental cost of their production. 2. The infrastructure strain. EVs rely on electricity, and as their adoption grows, so does the strain on electrical grids. In cities like Los Angeles and London, where EV ownership is highest, local grids have struggled to keep up. Blackouts during peak hours have forced governments to issue warnings about charging responsibly. Imagine needing to drive to work only to find that charging your car overnight wasn't possible. For many, this logistical headache outweighs the environmental benefits. 3. The wealth divide. EVs are expensive. There's no way around it. While governments offer subsidies to make them more accessible, these incentives often don't go far enough. Lower-income families are left out of the green revolution, unable to afford the high upfront costs. This has led to criticism that EVs are a luxury item rather than a solution for the masses. In some regions, officials argue that investments in EV infrastructure would be better spent on improving public transit or retrofitting existing gas-powered vehicles with cleaner technologies. These factors combine to create a perfect storm of challenges, leaving automakers, policymakers, and consumers questioning whether the EV revolution is truly sustainable. Part 2, the environmental trade-off. To understand the environmental impact of EVs, we need to start with their most critical component, the battery. At the heart of every EV battery lies lithium, a metal prized for its lightweight and high energy density. But mining lithium is far from green. The lithium triangle of South America, spanning Chile, Bolivia, and Argentina, is home to some of the world's largest lithium reserves. Here, lithium is extracted from underground brine pools, a process that requires millions of gallons of water. In Chile's Atacama Desert, Lithium mining has reduced freshwater availability by up to 65%, devastating local agriculture and threatening wildlife. For communities that have farmed this region for centuries, the consequences are catastrophic. And then there's cobalt, another critical material. Much of the world's cobalt comes from the Congo, where mining operations are often associated with the child labor and unsafe conditions. Despite promises from automakers to source materials responsibly, the reality is that demand for cobalt far outpaces ethical supply. As long as these practices continue, the EV industry will struggle to claim the moral high ground. The recycling dilemma. EV batteries don't last forever. After about 8 to 15 years, their performance declines, leaving the question, what happens next? Unfortunately, the answer isn't simple. Currently, only a fraction of EV batteries are recycled. Most end up in storage, waiting for a recycling solution that is both cost-effective and scalable. The process of recycling a battery is complicated and expensive. Extracting materials like lithium, cobalt, and nickel requires advanced technology that only a handful of companies possess. This has led to a growing stockpile of used batteries, with some experts warning of an impending waste crisis. If these batteries aren't properly disposed of, they could leak harmful chemicals into the soil and water, undoing much of the environmental progress EVs are meant to achieve. However, there's hope on the horizon. Companies like Redwood Materials and Li-Cycle are developing innovative recycling methods designed to recover up to 95% of a battery's valuable materials. If successful, these efforts could close the loop on EV production, making the industry more sustainable. But for now, these solutions remain in their infancy, leaving a significant gap in the system. Part 3: Infrastructure Nightmares. When we talk about the rise of EVs, the conversation often centers around their potential to save the planet. But there's a critical question many forget to ask. Can our infrastructure handle this transition? The answer for now seems to be a resounding no. Let's start with the electric grid, the backbone of our modern lives, and now the lifeline for millions of EVs. Electric grids worldwide were never designed to support the kind of demand brought on by widespread EV adoption. In the United States, the grid is already under immense pressure, especially in states like California, where EV ownership is booming. During the summer of 2022, the state faced record-breaking heat waves that pushed electricity usage to its limits. The government was forced to issue warnings urging residents to avoid charging their EVs during peak hours, leaving many drivers scrambling to find alternative solutions. The problem isn't isolated to California. In Germany, one of the world's leaders in green energy, small towns and rural areas have seen frequent power disruptions caused by EV charging. These grids, originally built to support homes and businesses, now have to accommodate an entirely new layer of demand. The result? Voltage drops, outages, and mounting frustration for residents. And it's not just about keeping the lights on. The investment required to modernize grids is astronomical. Experts estimate that upgrading the US grid to fully support EVs could cost $2 trillion by 2035. That's money many regions simply don't have, especially when faced with competing priorities like healthcare, education, and climate resilience. Developing nations face an even steeper climb, with grids that are already underfunded and prone to failure. The bottom line, while EVs promise a cleaner future, they're creating a logistical headache for utilities and governments worldwide. Without significant investment and innovation, the dream of an all-electric future could remain just that, a dream. The charging station problem. Now, let's move from the grid to the ground. Charging stations. In theory, charging your EV should be as easy as pulling into a gas station. But in practice, it's often anything but. For one, there's the issue of charging deserts. While urban centers like Los Angeles and New York City are teeming with chargers, rural areas remain largely underserved. Imagine living in a small town where the nearest charging station is 50 miles away. For many potential EV buyers, this lack of infrastructure is a deal breaker. It's no wonder that EV adoption rates in rural areas lag far behind their urban counterparts. Even in cities with plenty of chargers, the experience can be frustrating. Charging stations are often plagued by long wait times, especially during peak hours, and when you finally get to plug in, you might find that the station is out of order, an all-too-common occurrence. According to a study by the J.D. Power, nearly 1 in 5 public charging stations in the U.S. is either broken or unreliable. But then there's the issue of the compatibility. Unlike gas stations, which work for any car, EV chargers often cater to specific brands. Tesla's supercharger network, for example, is largely exclusive to Tesla vehicles, leaving drivers of other EVs EVs searching for alternatives. While some companies are working on universal adapters, the lack of standardization remains a significant hurdle. And let's not forget about charging speed. While filling up a gas tank takes just a few minutes, even the fastest EV chargers can take 30 minutes to an hour to provide a full charge. For many drivers, this added inconvenience outweighs the environmental benefits, maintenance, and hidden costs. Owning an EV comes with its own set of challenges, and maintenance is a big one. While EVs are often marketed as low maintenance compared to traditional cars, the reality is more complex. For starters, EV batteries, the heart of the vehicle, are incredibly expensive to replace. A new battery for a Tesla Model S can cost upwards of $20,000, or nearly as much as a new compact car. And while most batteries come with warranties that last 8 to 10 years, the prospect of a costly replacement is enough to make many buyers think twice. But the costs don't stop there. Many EV manufacturers have implemented the software locks that prevent independent mechanics from servicing their vehicles. This means that even minor repairs, like fixing a door handle or updating the software, often require a trip to the dealership. And as any car owner knows, dealership repairs come with a hefty price tag. This lack of repair freedom has sparked outrage among consumers and advocacy groups. The right to repair movement has been vocal in its criticism, arguing that manufacturers are prioritizing profits over customer convenience. And they're not wrong. EV repair monopolies have become a lucrative business, with dealerships charging premium rates for even the simplest fixes. For now, EV owners are stuck in a system that feels increasingly restrictive. While the promise of lower fuel costs is appealing, the hidden costs of maintenance and repairs can quickly add up, leaving many to wonder if the trade-offs are worth it. Part 4, social and economic impacts. The rise of EVs isn't just changing how we drive, it's reshaping the entire automotive industry, and for workers in this sector, the transition has been anything but smooth. Traditional automakers, long reliant on internal combustion engines, ICE, are now racing to adapt to the electric age, but building EVs requires fewer workers as the vehicles have the fewer moving parts. This efficiency is great for manufacturers, but devastating for employees. A report by the United Auto Workers, UAW, estimates that the shift to EVs could result in the loss of 30% of jobs in the automotive sector. Take the town of Lordsburg, Ohio, for example. For decades, the local GM plant was the backbone of the community, providing stable jobs and supporting small businesses. But as the plant transitions to EV production, hundreds of workers have been laid off, with little hope of finding comparable work. While EV manufacturing has created new opportunities in battery plants and software development, these jobs often require specialized skills, leaving many ICE workers struggling to adapt. It's not just automakers feeling the heat. The oil and gas industry, which has long profited from traditional vehicles, is also grappling with the rise of EVs. Gas stations, mechanics, and parts suppliers are bracing for a future where their services may no longer be needed, threatening the livelihoods of thousands. The EV divide. While EVs promise a brighter future, they're also exposing a stark economic divide. For many, the high cost of entry is a significant barrier. Even with government subsidies, the Tesla Model 3, often touted as the affordable EV option, still costs over $40,000. For families living paycheck to paycheck, this price tag is simply out of reach. Government incentives aim to bridge this gap, but they often come with strings attached. In the US, for example, the full $7,500 EV tax credit is only available for certain models and income brackets. This means that while wealthier households benefit from these programs, lower income families are often left out. This economic divide raises important questions about the fairness of the EV transition. Are we creating a two-tier transportation system where the wealthy enjoy the benefits of clean energy while the rest are left behind? And if so, what does that mean for the millions of Americans still relying on gas-powered cars? The global ripple effect. The EV revolution isn't just reshaping industries, it's altering global economic dynamics. As countries push for stricter emission standards, automakers are racing to electrify their fleets. But this rapid shift is creating challenges, especially for developing nations. Take India, where the government has ambitious plans to electrify its public transport system. While these goals are commendable, the country's limited access to EV resources, like lithium and cobalt, poses a significant hurdle. Without Without a robust supply chain, India risks becoming dependent on foreign imports, leaving its economy vulnerable to price fluctuations. Meanwhile, in China, the government's massive investments in EV infrastructure have given Chinese automakers a significant edge. Companies like BYD and NIO are now exporting EVs to Europe and beyond, challenging legacy automakers like Ford and Toyota. This shift is reshaping global trade dynamics, with some experts warning of a potential EV trade war. For consumers, these changes could mean higher prices, fewer choices, and longer wait times for new vehicles. It's a reminder that the EV revolution, while promising, comes with its own set of challenges. Insurance nightmares. When it comes to owning an electric vehicle, most people focus on the environmental benefits or fuel savings. But one major aspect often overlooked is the insurance costs, which can be a nasty surprise for new EV owners. Insuring an EV typically costs 20% to 40% more than insuring a comparable gas-powered vehicle. Why? It all boils down to the repair complexity and specialized components. EVs are packed with cutting-edge technology, from their batteries to advanced sensors. While these features make EVs safer and more efficient, they also make them expensive to repair. For instance, a small accident that damages the battery casing could cost thousands of dollars to fix, even if the damage appears minor. Take Tesla, for example. The Model 3, touted as an affordable EV, has insurance rates that can rival luxury vehicles. One Tesla owner in California reported paying over $2,000 annually for basic coverage, more than double what they'd pay for a Toyota Camry. And it's not just Tesla. Other EV brands face similar challenges, with insurers citing the high cost of replacement parts and the limited number of repair facilities as key reasons for the price hike. Even worse, insurers are increasingly opting to write off EVs as total losses instead of repairing them. Why? Because the cost of fixing a damaged EV battery or recalibrating its software often exceeds the car's value. Imagine being in a minor fender bender and having your car deemed irreparable, not because it's unsafe to drive, but because the economics of repair don't make sense. This practice leaves many EV owners frustrated, particularly when they receive a payout that isn't enough to buy a comparable replacement. For consumers, the higher insurance premiums and increased likelihood of total losses add an unexpected layer of cost to EV ownership. These challenges are prompting calls for insurers to rethink their pricing models and for automakers to design more repairable vehicles. Until then, buyers need to factor in insurance as a significant part of their total cost of ownership. Battery degradation and resale value. Another hidden challenge of EV ownership lies in a battery degradation, which has a direct impact on the vehicle's resale value. Unlike traditional gas-powered cars, where mileage is the key factor, the health of an EV's battery determines its long-term worth. EV batteries, typically made from lithium-ion technology, lose capacity over time. Most manufacturers claim that their batteries will retain 70% to 80% of their original capacity after 8 to 10 years. While that sounds reassuring, real-world performance can vary dramatically depending on factors like climate, charging habits, and usage. For instance, drivers in hot climates like Arizona or Texas may see their batteries degrade faster due to the impact of heat on lithium-ion cells. Similarly, frequent fast charging, while convenient, can accelerate wear and tear on the battery. Over time, this degradation reduces the vehicle's range, making it less appealing to potential buyers in the used car market. This issue is particularly significant for older EV models like the Nissan Leaf, which lacks modern battery cooling systems found in newer vehicles. A 7-year-old Leaf, for example, might only offer to 50 miles of range on a full charge, down from its original 150 miles. For many buyers, that limited range makes the car impractical, forcing sellers to accept steep discounts. Replacing an EV battery is an option, but it's not cheap. Depending on the make and model, a new battery can cost anywhere from $5,000 to $20,000, often rivaling the value of the car itself. This creates a catch-22. Owners are reluctant to invest in a replacement battery, but without one, their car's resale value plummets. For the EV industry, this poses a long-term challenge. Manufacturers are investing in solid-state battery technology, which promises longer lifespans and reduced degradation. But until these innovations become mainstream, battery wear will continue to be a significant pain point for EV owners. Part 6, the road ahead. The transition to electric vehicles isn't just an engineering challenge, it's a political battlefield. Around the world, governments are grappling with how to balance ambitious climate goals with the practical realities of EV adoption. The result? A patchwork of policies that vary wildly from one region to another. Take the European Union, for instance. Countries like Norway, which aims to ban gas-powered car sales by 2025, are leading the charge with aggressive subsidies and infrastructure investments. Meanwhile, nations like Poland and Hungary, where EV adoption is slower, argue that these targets are unrealistic. For them, the lack of charging stations and the high cost of EVs make an all-electric future seem more like a pipe dream than a viable strategy. In the United States, the debate is even more polarized. States like California have enacted some of the world's strictest emission standards, with plans to phase out gas-powered cars entirely by 2035. Yet other states, such as Wyoming and Texas, have pushed back against federal EV mandates. Their argument, EV policies are out of touch with the needs of rural communities and industries like trucking, which rely heavily on diesel-powered vehicles. This tug of war creates uncertainty for automakers, who must navigate conflicting regulations while trying to plan for the future. Should they focus on producing EVs to meet California's ambitious targets, or hedge their bets by continuing to develop gas and hybrid models for states with looser rules? For now, there's no clear answer. Adding to the complexity is public skepticism. While many Americans support the idea of cleaner energy, they're wary of the costs. A recent survey found that 56% of respondents believe EV mandates are being implemented too quickly, without adequate infrastructure to support them. This hesitation is a significant hurdle for policymakers, who must convince voters that the benefits of electrification outweigh the challenges. Innovations that could change everything. Despite these hurdles, the EV industry is far from slowing down. In fact, some of the most exciting technological innovations are on the horizon, promising to address the very issues holding back widespread adoption. And one of the most talked about breakthroughs is solid-state batteries. Unlike traditional lithium-ion batteries, solid-state versions use a solid electrolyte, which allows for greater energy density, faster charging, and significantly longer lifespans. Companies like Toyota and QuantumScape are at the forefront of this technology, with prototypes already showing promising results. If these batteries hit the market, they could eliminate many of the concerns about range and battery degradation, making EVs a more attractive option for consumers. Another game-changer is wireless charging technology. Imagine pulling into your garage and having your car charge automatically, without the need for cables or plugs. This technology, already being tested in cities like Oslo, could make EV ownership far more convenient, addressing one of the biggest pain points for drivers. And let's not forget about the recycling innovations. With concerns about the environmental impact of mining for lithium and cobalt, companies like the Redwood Materials are developing ways to recover up to 95% of valuable materials from used EV batteries. This closed-loop system could significantly reduce the industry's reliance on raw materials, lowering costs and making EVs more sustainable. Finally, some automakers are exploring synthetic fuels as an alternative to electrification. These fuels, made from renewable energy and captured carbon, offer a way to power traditional combustion engines with net zero emissions. While still in its infancy, this technology has the potential to coexist with EVs, providing another path toward a greener future.